안녕하세요. Welcome back to Korean Saturday School. Today is December 5th, and actually, today is going to be our last lesson of the year. Yay! Finally, we're going to have our winter break. Actually, we're going to have a break up until the spring semester, which is going to start again in on February 2nd. I'm gonna leave the announcements towards the end of the lesson, but yeah, today's our last lesson. So welcome back. This is the New York 초대한국 문화학교, and this is our last lesson. So, 안녕하세요. 환영합니다. My name is Sarang Kim or Kim Sarang 선생님, and I am in charge of the 진달래반. So, today's lesson, so normally we would do 3 lessons a day in our blue book, this one, but today we're only going to do 2, just because I want to learn it more in depth, and because it's our last lesson, I decided to make it a little shorter. So you can find today's lesson on page 95 through 101, it's in this book that looks like this. If you don't have it, the pages are on the slides. Just make sure you have a pencil and paper. Okay. So, yep, last week of class, guys. Let's survive this one more week and then have an awesome break. All right, so if we look at page 95, the title of today's lesson is 신호등 지키기. 신호등 지키기. Okay. And it should look something like this. Okay, let's look at this page. Everyone turn to page 95. And on the top it should say 신호등 지키기. 다음 그림을 보고 낱말을 읽어보세요. Okay. So let's read the dialogue. It says 빨간 신호등 멈추기. And then 초록 신호등 천천히 건너기. All right, so what does this mean? 신호등 지키기. 신호등 지키기means respect the traffic light. So it can mean respect or like follow, because when we cross the street, we have to look at the traffic light to see if we have to stop or if we can go. So the 빨간색, the red color, 신호등 means stop. And then the green color, the 초록 신호등 means it means walk, but in this case, the girl is walking a little slowly because she has a pet dog. So 초록 신호등 천천히 건너기. 건너기 is to cross, so crossing the street. So, but she's walking slowly, okay? So I want you guys on a separate piece of paper to write the vocabulary words on the next slide right here, because we're gonna get tested on it, okay? Everyone, let's go to the next page. Okay, so number 2. 선생님과 함께 다음 글을 읽어보세요. Okay, we're going to read this together. 비 오는 날 나는 노란 신발과 노란 우산. 너는 파란 신발과 파란 우산. 나와 너는 친구. Okay, now let's break this down. So 비 오는 날, on a rainy day, 나는 노란 신발과 노란 우산. I mean, I have or wear yellow shoes and I use a yellow umbrella. Okay, so 노란, 노란 신발, yellow shoes, 노란 우산, yellow umbrella. And then 너는 파란 신발과 파란 우산. You have blue shoes and a blue umbrella. 나와 너는 친구. That means you and I are friends. Okay, so two friends on a rainy day. One's wearing yellow, one's wearing blue. Now let's read the bottom. 자동차가 지나가요. 길을 건널 때는 신호등을 잘 보고 손을 들고 천천히 건너요. Alright, so 자동차가 지나가요. There is a car passing. 길을 건널 때는 신호등을 잘 보고 So when you're crossing the street, you have to look at the traffic light and 손을 들고 천천히 건너요. And it says raise your hand and slowly cross the street. Now, raising your hand is something a lot of little kids do just because when somebody is driving, they sometimes the car is elevated so the driver can't see like little kids that are short and tiny. So a lot of the time kids, young kids are taught to raise their hand when they cross the street so that cars are able to see that there's somebody crossing the street. If you want to do this, you can still do it for your safety. But if not, always look at the signal and watch carefully for cars. Okay, so let's go over some of the vocabulary words for this page. So a disclaimer before I go on, I'm just going to explain the difference between 노란 and 노랑. Okay, so they both describe the color yellow. Okay, so but one is a noun and one is an adjective. So the one with the 이응 is the noun. So 노랑 would be just yellow. So the color itself is yellow, so it's just 노랑. But when we're describing something that is yellow, we say the word 노란. We put the 니은, okay? Instead of the 이응 here, we put a 니은. So 노란 신발, those are yellow shoes. 노란 우산, yellow umbrella. But 노랑 is just plainly yellow. It's a little difficult, but because the difference is very subtle, but that is a difference, and we have to be aware of when to use what word, okay? So let me just go over the colors first then. So 노랑 is yellow, 파랑 is blue, and 빨, okay, this one, I put 빨간색 just because we need to use that word later on, but it would be 빨강. If I were just to say red, but the color red to describe things, we would say 빨간색, 빨간색. Okay. I hope that made sense. It's a little confusing, but yeah. But if we were just to say the color, we would say 빨강 instead of 빨간. Okay. So the second word here, 신발. 신발 means shoes. And then 우산. 우산 is umbrella. 우산 is umbrella. 신호등. 신호등 is traffic light. And then 손 is hand. 천천히. 천천히 is slowly. And 건너. 건너 means cross. Okay? So take your time to write down these words on a piece of paper or in your notebook because we're going to get tested later, okay? Pause the video if you need more time, but otherwise, let's move on. Okay, so let's go to the next page, page 97. Let's do some practice questions. So number one, it says, 내가 가지고 있는 물건에 이름을 빈칸에 쓰세요. Okay, so look at the object and then finish writing it. So we see 노란 신발, right? And here we see 노란 우산. So we're going to write 신발 here and 우산 here. Okay, I want you guys to write it and then I'll show you on the screen. So here you write 신발. And 우산. Okay, so how do we spell that? It would be 신발, 우산. Okay. Always challenge yourself and try to do the things before I show you the answer. Okay, number two, blank blank 색, 신 blank blank. Okay, so we see 신호등 here. So that would be this part, 신호등. And then what color is it? Because it ends in 색. It is currently red. So how do you say red color? 신호등. We would say 빨간색 신호등. Okay. So 빨간 goes here. 호등 goes here. 신호등. So 빨간색 신호등. That means red traffic light, red stoplight. Okay, number three. 틀린 글자를 찾아 빈칸에 바르게 고쳐 쓰세요. Okay, so for this one, it's a little different. We're gonna find the error in this word, and then we're gonna fix it. Okay, so it says 파란 신발. 신발. What's 신발? Right? The error is here. So I'm pretty sure they're trying to say blue shoes. 파란 신발. So it should be 파란 신발 with the 니은. Instead of this 이응 right here, there should be a 니은. So 파란 신발. That is the correct word. All right. So last one. 다음 그림을 보고 알맞는 말을 써보세요. Okay, so we see a man and a younger girl, and she's bowing. So in Korean culture, when we see anyone older than us, we 인사, okay? So 어른 보고 인사하기. 어른 보고 인사하기. We do a bow, we say 안녕하세요. And then when they leave, we say 안녕히 가세요 or 안녕히 계세요, right? So this is just a form of respect and a form of greeting in Korean culture, okay? So 어른 보고 인사하기. Okay? Always make sure to 인사 to adults. Okay, and for those of you who didn't get all the vocab, here it is one more time. Pause the video, quickly write it down. Write it down 2 to 3 times with the definition in English so you guys are familiar with how to write it, okay? And then now we're going to have our test. So usually the test will be on the next page, but we're not doing that. I stopped doing that just because not all of the words that are the answers to these tests are in the lesson. So I didn't want to give you words that we didn't learn or don't know. So I'm just going to give you guys 6 words, and you guys are going to write it down on a piece of paper. So listen carefully to what I'm saying and write the correct word. I'm going to repeat everything more than twice. I'm only supposed to do it twice, but just more than twice for the sake. Okay, so listen carefully. Okay, so if everyone is ready, I'm going to start. The first word is 빨간색. 빨간색. It was 빨간색. 색. Number 2. 신발. 신발. Number 3. 건너. 건너. Number 4. 우산. 우산. Number 5. 신호등. 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 Last one, number 6. 손, 손. Okay, so if you're done, I'm gonna just repeat everything one more time. First one is 빨간색. 오케이, okay, number two was 신발. Three was 건너. Four is 우산. 우산. Five is 신호등. And the last one was 손. Okay. Hopefully you guys had enough time. Review your answers one more time, and then I'm going to show you guys the correct answers. Okay, so the first one was 빨간색. That means the color red. When we describe things that are the color red. Two is 신발, which are shoes. Three is 건너, means cross. Four is 우산, means umbrella. Five is 신호등, which is traffic light. Last one, 손, is hand. Okay, so pause the video, check your answers. Make sure if you got it right, give yourself a check. If you got it wrong, make sure to correct it, okay? Rewrite it a couple of more times if you got it wrong, just to get familiar with it so you don't get it wrong next time. Okay, so let's move on to our second lesson. Second lesson we can find on page 99. And the title for this one is 우리 학교 음악 잔치. 우리 학교 음악 잔치. Okay. 우리 학교 음악 잔치 초대합니다. 친구들 박수 쳐 주세요. Okay. So 우리 학교 음악 잔치에 초대합니다 means we invite you to our school's music festival. And 친구들 박수 쳐 주세요. Means friends, please clap your hands. Okay. All right. Let's go to the next page. 네, 선생님과 함께 다음 글을 읽어 보세요. So the first one we see 즐거운 학교. 즐거운 학교. That means fun school. I don't know if that's the case for many of you guys, but this school is a fun school. Okay, so 음악 시간. 음악 시간 is music time. 고운 목소리, 둥둥 북소리, 악기를 연주해요. Okay, so 고운 목소리 means very soft voice. So it means that person that's singing has a very lovely voice. And then 둥둥 북소리. 둥둥 북소리. The drums make a 둥둥 sound. Okay? And then 악기를 연주해요 means we play the instrument. 수학 시간. 수학 시간 is math time. 여러 가지 모양을 만들어요. So during math we make different kinds of shapes. And then 체육 시간. 체육 시간 is gym time, our favorite time of the day, my favorite time. 오늘은 축구를 해요. 공을 막아요. Today we play soccer and then I block the ball. So once again, copy down these vocabulary words after I go over them. Copy them a couple of times. So the first word is 학교. 학교. 학교 is school. 음악. 음악 is music. 목소리. 목소리 is voice. And then 북소리. 북소리 is the drum sound. Okay, realize how the difference between 목소리 and 북소리 is just the first part. So 목. 목 is your throat. So 소리 means sound. So sound from your 목 is your voice. And then 북소리, sound from a 북 is drum sound. Okay? And then 악기 is instrument. 수학 is math. 축구 is soccer. 막아요 means block. 박수 is clap. 친구, why did I put 친구? I don't see 친구 here. You guys can skip that. Okay, let's go on to the next page. Let's do some practice problems. Number one.
체육 시간에는 무엇을 하나요?
What do we do during gym time? So over here it says, 오늘은 축구를 해요. So we're going to write 축구. And number two, 즐거운. What is this? This building right here is the school. So we're going to write 즐거운 학교. 즐거운 학교. Should look like this. And then number three,
그림에 어울리는 낱말을 연결하고 따라 써보세요.
Okay, so let's look at the picture and connect it to the word on the bottom. So it says 수학 on the left, and it says 음악 on the right. So anything related with 수학, we're going to draw a line. Anything related with 음악, we're going to draw a line. So match the picture. So what do you think matches with math, and what do you think matches with music? I'm going to give you some time to answer it, and then I'll show you that. All right, so it should look something like this. So remember the geometric shapes that we put together in math class are related to math. So the triangle and the square. And then music are these instruments that are shown. Okay, it should look something like that. All right, so number four, this is another example, but they say, 내 작은 척척 박사. Okay. So this basically means my partner is 척척 박사, an expert. 박사 is like, 박사 is someone that is very knowledgeable in something, so a professor, or you can say a scientist, or someone that's very, very, very intelligent. Okay, that's 박사님. Okay, but since we're done with the examples, we're going to go on to our quiz. Remember, we're skipping this page. We're skipping page 102, and I'm going to give you 6 words, and you guys are going to write it down. So get your piece of paper, and we're just going to take the quiz. Okay, so number one is 수학. 수학. Number two, 음악. 음악. Number three, 학교. 학교. Number four, 박수. 박수. Number five, 축구. 축구. Number six, last one, 악기. 악기. Okay, I'm going to repeat everything one more time. So number one was 수학, 수학. Number two is 음악, 음악. Three is 학교, 학교. Four is 박수, 박수. Five is 축구, 축구. Last one, six, 악기, 악기. Okay, so finish up writing your words, and then in a few seconds, I'm going to show the answer. So it should look something like this. Number one was 수학, 수학. Number two was 음악. 수학 is math. 음악 is music. Three, 학교. 학교 is school. 박수. 박수 means clap. 축구. 축구 means soccer. And 악기 means instrument. Okay? So if you got all of these right, give yourself a pat on the back. If you got some wrong, make sure to correct it. Okay? I'm just going to say a few announcements before we end today's class. So we're going to be having Christmas gift distributions and spring semester registration. And when is this going to take place? It's going to be from December 17 to 19. So for 3 days, December 17, 18, 19 at 뉴욕초대교회 from 10 to 2, so 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. You guys can come like with your parents to pick up Christmas gifts. So we're going to be giving you guys free gifts for the holidays. And also, during these days, we're going to be taking registrations for the spring semester. So the reason you guys have to register for the spring is because we need to know how many materials we need to prepare for the spring semester. And also, from February 2nd to February 6th is the day you guys will actually come to pick up your textbooks and the materials that we need for the spring semester, okay? So pre-registers are going to be open. Make sure you guys can come. 부모님들께 알립니다. 12월 17일, 18일, 그리고 19일에 뉴욕 초대교회에서 크리스마스 선물을 나눠줄 건데요. 크리스마스 선물이랑 또 봄학기 등록을 받을 건데요. 왜냐하면 봄학기 시작하려면 우리가 몇 명이 나올 건지 그리고 재료는 얼마나 준비해야 하는지 알아야 되니까 등록하시면 되고요. 10시에서 2시 사이에 오시면 돼요. 그리고 우리 봄학기가 2월 13일부터 시작할 거고요. 그 전에 2월 2일에서 6일까지 우리가 재료를 나눠줄 거예요. 그것도 교회에서 나눠줄 거고요. 봄학기는 2월 13일부터 시작할 겁니다. That's the end for the announcements. Thank you guys for watching. This is the end. Thank you guys for joining us on this journey of online 한글학교. And 한글학교 in the spring is also probably going to be through YouTube. So stay tuned. We'll keep you updated. And I will not see you guys next week because today is the last class. So scratch that. And happy holidays. Merry Christmas. And also happy new year to everybody. Thank you guys for joining and have a nice day. Bye.